Steve Harrigan's our man in Tripoli, streaming live there tonight. We're hearing of new strikes there, Steve.
Shepard, those strikes happened when we spoke to you in the 3 o'clock hour. Two large explosions sounded like perhaps cruise missile attacks. We're getting unconfirmed reports that a military base to the east of the city here was targeted. And as is usual for the sixth night in a row, after those attacks, we saw anti-aircraft fire stream up into the air. Those red tracer bullets going around the city in daytime the other day, we could see many of those anti-aircraft placements. They're basically large guns about the size and shape to fill up the back of an open-end pickup truck, usually operated by two men, a bunch of other soldiers in a tent along the side of the road. Those positions really all over this capital city. Those are manually operated and largely ineffective against fighter jets. So that's why the jets now really flying with impunity over Libya's capital, Shepard.
So the state television over there is claiming recent airstrikes have killed a lot of civilians.
That's right. State TV here is showing the pictures in the morgue of what they say are civilians killed by these airstrikes. They're also taking journalists out to funerals, again, they say, of civilians killed. This is going to shape up to be a real public relations battle between coalition forces and the government here. Of course, civilian casualties have the ability to really inflame popular opinion against any campaign. Already striking back, U.S. military officials are saying they have caused minimal or no civilian casualties. The one who is killing civilians, they say, is Colonel Gaddafi, by having cities like Misrata under siege, where the main hospital there has had its electricity and water cut. They say he's the one killing the civilians.
Steve Harrigan, our eyes and ears from Tripoli tonight. Steve, thanks very much.